they know my voice. And we hear just a bit of that 10th chapter of the Good Shepherd's narrative, where Jesus explains to us by using himself and God as the shepherd. And sheep
will know their shepherd's voice, that when their shepherd calls, they follow him. And so we're asked to be able to know our shepherd's voice, the voice of Christ. But when we hear that voice, do we know it? Maybe we respond to it as those people in the first reading, that is Paul and Barnabas. It said, a great multitude gathered to hear the word of God. But then when they heard it, they didn't like it, and so they spoke against it. But we need, in our jobs, in our faith, to learn the voice of Christ, to learn the voice of our shepherd, so that when we hear it, we can know and we can follow it. Now, some time ago, this is, I think a lot of people have a time that, you know, when you know you should go to bed, but instead you're flipping through the channels saying, well, maybe something will be good. And I found something actually really interesting. I found the Paralympics were on, and they were having the sport, it has another name, but blind soccer, soccer for the blind. And I played soccer my whole life, so this was really interesting to me in that all of the players are, most of the players are visually impaired. And even then, they have to wear a blindfold so that they can't see. And the ball, regular soccer ball, except inside it, there's bells, so they can hear where the ball is. But even on top of that, they get two people are allowed sight. The goalie can be able to see, because it'd be really hard to stop a ball flying at you if all you're going off of is noise. And then each team to the side has a guide, someone who's allowed to shout to his team to give directions, although they can't play themselves, and he's a sighted person. And it was amazing to see the skill that these people played with just by going off of sound, off of hearing the ball, and getting some directives from this guide. And so I thought, what a great way to kind of show how important it is to listen. And so I got a blind soccer ball, and I did it with the youth group there. They weren't quite as skilled as the professional blind soccer players. There was two really big problems they ran into. The first one was when they would hear, because when we started out, we learned pretty quickly that it's important to separate the guides, because otherwise, both the guides are shouting different directions, and the players don't know who to follow. And so everyone's following the wrong guide because they don't know super well the voice of their guide. And in our spiritual life, a lot of times we have a lot of guides shouting at us. And if we don't know which voice it is to hear, if we aren't able to separate out the right guide, the exact same thing happens as what happened to that youth group. Chaos and running into each other and people falling over and getting hurt. Now that happens in our spiritual life, that we'll hear God's voice, but it's one of a lot of voices. It's one of many voices in the world that's calling us to different things. But then on top of that, there's also the players who hear the voice, who know exactly what they're being told to say, but they're saying, I hear the ball, I'm just going to go for it. I'm going to do what I think is right and ignore that voice. And it's really easy to fall into that too, to say, well, I know what I want. Yeah, I hear God's voice in there. But God will see. If I do this, he's going to be like, wow, that was a way better plan. He'll figure out that my way, my plan is going to work. Or other times we just get really good at convincing ourselves. Maybe we use that transitive property and say, well, God wants me to be happy. And cookies make me happy. Therefore, God wants me to eat cookies. Lawless logic. But it doesn't quite work that way. That yes, God wants us to be happy, but his voice, the voice that's calling out to us, that shepherd's voice, is calling us to a greater good, a good that we might not be able to see right now, that we might be the blindfolded one hearing that ball and saying, if I run straight for it as fast as I can, I'm going to get that ball. Where God is shouting out, hold on a second, it's coming towards you. If you don't move, you can get it. Or no, turn around, go this way, that we can't see, and it doesn't quite seem to make logical sense to us off of our senses, that we can't do what every part of us is saying, do this now. But that's really the best path, because there's one who has a bigger view, who has more than one sense, and we need to train ourselves to listen to that. Too often we hear God's voice, and we treat it as we treat our GPS, that we say, oh no, I know the way from here, and I'm going to go this way, and it's the good way, and if anything goes wrong, then what happens? Redirecting. That God's good at planning, right? I can just do what I want, and if it doesn't work out, well, his plan's great. He'll redirect me. I'll get there eventually. Instead of just listening to that. I mean, now the GPSs are awesome. They'll route you around traffic. They'll take you down these back ways. There's stuff that we don't know coming our way. And the voice of God, the voice of our shepherd, is the one doing that. And I know we don't like to be compared to those sheep who just kind of aren't known to be the smartest of animals. But they don't need to have that much thought, that much thing, when they have trust. And it is important that we bring our reason to faith. Never doubt that. It's important that we use our minds. But it's important that we don't put our minds and what voices we hear in ourself replace the voice of the shepherd. Because if we're constantly following our own voice, if we don't take time and silence in our lives to learn the voice of the shepherd, to learn what it sounds like when God is speaking to us, then it's really easy to confuse that for our own. And then that voice that's saying, cookies are good and God wants me to have cookies, doesn't just stop at cookies. That our own interior monologue becomes that voice of God. That if the voice of God, the voice of the shepherd, never challenges you, it's probably not the voice of God. It's probably our own voice just letting us do what we want and saying, but God wants me to be happy. God does want us to be happy, but he has a plan. He has a route that just as the shepherd knows the areas to avoid, he knows where the green pastures are and the sheep don't. Just as in those Paralympics, the guides are able to tell the players who to pass to, where the position is, where they should go, where they should turn. And those players learn to trust them. They learn to listen to that voice and trust that it understands something that they might not right now. And because of that, they're able to play. Their skill gets better. They continue to get better and better until they're at that level of playing on the Olympics of blind soccer. They are able to do things that I could never dream of doing with a blindfold because they've learned to listen and follow the voice of the one who doesn't let them down. They've learned that trust, but it's a building process. It's why we come to Mass. It's why we listen to this word of God again and again. I'll let you know a secret. After you've been to three years of Sunday Masses, you've heard it all. We're not hiding anything. You've heard all the gospel in there. But we keep coming back because we still need to keep learning that voice. We still need to keep hearing the messages that are held in there. We keep needing to learn to recognize that voice of God that we know for a fact comes from God, so that when we go out into the world, when we have a bunch of guides shouting out, go here, do this, shoot now, that we can say, hold on, let me listen to that voice that I know. It's probably not the loudest voice. It's probably not always the one telling me exactly what I think, but I've listened to this voice. I know him. I know how he speaks. I've received him into me in the Eucharist. I've confessed him the deepest and darkest things that I've done, and he's forgiven me. And because of that, because he cares for me and loves me and will continue to do so, I'll have the trust in that little voice that's telling me to do something I don't want to do, or that's telling me to turn to a way that just doesn't quite make sense to me. I'll trust that that's a blindfold in my eye and that the Lord is being my guide. He's being my shepherd, guiding me along. But to have that faith, to have that trust, it doesn't come easy. You need to spend that time. Spend time in silence. Spend time in prayer. And in prayer, we're not supposed to be talking all the time. We're supposed to give that time to listen, to say, God, this is your go. I'm going to sit here. Maybe it'll be a little voice. Maybe it'll be an emotion. Maybe I won't get anything right now. But I'm going to give you that time because you deserve that time, because you're my shepherd, and I want to learn the way you speak. I want to hear your voice so that I can be the flock who hears and follows, so that I'm not those Jews in the first one who say, yes, yes, we want to hear the word of God right up until we hear the word of God. To be like Paul, doing everything wrong until he heard that voice. It says, I'm changing my life. To be those disciples who scared, didn't know what to do after Christ died. But because they paid attention, because Christ rose again and gave them the directives, we're able to hear him. We're able to go out and follow the things that they never would have dreamed to do themselves. All because they heard the voice of that shepherd. So spend time in prayer. Spend that time listening. Ask the Lord, Lord, let me hear your voice and let me know it. So that when we're bombarded by different guides, when we want to do our own thing, that we can say, no. Where's the voice of God? Where's the voice of the shepherd, the one who knows me, who loves me, who guides me, always putting me first, even if I don't understand what that means? That we can listen to the voice, that we can listen to the risen Christ, and that we can follow him as sheep and get that promise he gave us, the promise that everyone that the Father gave him cannot be taken if we but hear his voice and follow. Amen.